Good afternoon, and welcome you learners into the study of post 313 titled History of Political Thought, and also welcome you into the fourth semester, the Department of Political Science, University of Ibadan. I'm Olorunntobi Ayobami, a lecturer in charge of the course post 313. And first and foremost, traditionally, what we do as a teacher to the study of the history of political thought is to give you the general background, which we call the general overview of the course. This serves as a stickler, and it depicts how you are going to have a veritable grasp or knowledge about the course. In this connection, I quickly, you know, give you the general overview of the course, that is the term of political thought. Now, the term political thought is often used synonymously with political philosophy. In fact, political thought is a part of political philosophy. But now, in this course, we shall saddle ourselves or concern ourselves with political thought. That is the brief general overview of the course title. But let me quickly go further within the context of the general overview to let you understand that philosophy, it happens to be the model of all courses in this contemporary era. That is, philosophy happens to be the first originated course where all other disciplines, you know, actually emerged. Now, coming to the study session one, that means that political philosophy and political thought, as I exposed it in the first or the general overview, are twin brothers and sisters, often used interchangeably and synonymous with each other as the nomenclatures depict. That is the nomenclature of philosophy and the nomenclature of political thought. Political thought is part of philosophy, as philosophy is said to be the first course to be originated, as I told you in the general overview. In this study, we shall concern ourselves with the business of political thought. Now, there's something you have to understand as learners. When you have studied this session, you should be able to saddle yourselves with, number one, to define and use correctly some of the key words printed in bold, that is in your material, course material, and also to explain how the environment impinges on political thought. And let me quickly explain this. You see, environmental factor is very, very crucial and very important to any development. It is applicable to human beings and non-human beings, like trees. The environment that trains live depicts how the train, you know, looks like. And also, the environment that any human being lives depicts how far such human being can grow. And also, to explain two kind of political thoughts that you have read or that you know in your materials, and also identify five sources, I repeat, five sources, you know, of the political thought. So in this connection, the study session one goes properly in brief analysis, conceptualization, you know, of the political thought subject matter. That is, in this study session one, you understand the definition, kinds, sources, and effect of environment on political thought. Now, the concept of political thought. Before we go into the political thought of major well-known political philosophers from the period or era of down, that is Plato to Mills. From Plato to Mills, these philosophers are called classical philosophers. Please, I want you to understand. They are called classical or medieval philosophers. It is important to elucidate the concept of political thought and to explain how the milieu shaped the thought of the major political writers, as well as the kind and sources of political thought. It is said that man by nature is confronted by an array or water of problems. You know, naturally, man is confronted by array of problems. And the moment you know that, and that is why, as you learners, we are impacting on you the independent, constructive, and ideation knowledge. That is the knowledge to solve problems around you. That is what we call knowledge. If you acquire knowledge and the knowledge cannot solve the environment around you, that means you don't have knowledge, because it is said, charity begins at home. So you must understand the natural problems that are being confronted, you know, by man. Man is confronted with the problems of forming a state for the adequate protection and lives and property, and the provision of, you know, wills of the state to enhance the good life or agenda. So when you solve problems, it takes you to a realm where you enjoy what you have solved. So that is the basic, you know, fundamental, you know, philosophy behind, you know, the, you know, political thought. So what we are trying to let you, you know, understand, you know, here is that political thought is an innermost philosophy in a man that distinguishes a man from animal, to be able to solve the problems around him, for him to enjoy, and for the generation yet, you know, unborn to enjoy. In this connection, no, for the citizenry, he is confronted with the problems of identifying and adopting the best form of government. Like today, we are saying democracy is the best form of government. So this, the concept of democracy in itself was given back to through human political thought. And having given back to the concept of democracy, now democracy was now put into operation. And today, democracy is adjudged as the best form of, you know, government in order for it to solve governmental problems that are being confronted by the, you know, humanity. So, now, he is confronted with problems of identifying and adopting the best form of government. He is confronted with the problem of peace, justice, stability, etc. And also, Plato happens to be one of the most famous or classical or medieval philosopher, of ancient Greece, was the first to use the term philosophy. Please take note that Plato was the first Greek philosopher to use the term philosophy. That is the knowledge, okay, or the search for knowledge. Let us put it in another way. Search or love for knowledge. Born around 428 BC, Plato, it is said, investigated a wide range of topics. Chief among his ideas was the theory of forms, which proposed that objects in the physical world merely, you know, resemble perfect forms in the ideal world, and that the only, you know, this perfect form can be the object of true knowledge. So what we are talking about is that, you know, these classical philosophers, they were able to, you know, form or, you know, thought about, you know, ideal society, which we are still battling, you know, with till today. However, all these aforesaid problems made by man start thinking of how to find adequate and appropriate solution to his political problems. Because when you are confronted with a problem, you must be up and doing in order for you to find solutions to it. And that is the beauty of education. Remember that the Bible says, my people suffer for lack of wisdom. So I say from the scholarly world that my people suffer for lack of philosophy. And when you lack philosophy, you lack everything. In this connection, the solution that was taught and put forward by man to solve his political problems in society became what I refer to as political thoughts. So, I've given you a very brief historical birth and development of a political thought. Now, it is good for us to understand better political society is also political thought, because I told you that the states and finding lasting solutions to the problem of the state was as a result of the part of political thought. Hence, Sabine G. H. and Thomas T. L. 1973 define political theory as a man's attempt to consciously understand and solve the problem of his group, life, and organization. They also view political thought as any knowledge about politics or relevant to politics. In addition, the state is the birth of political thought, where human beings, rationally, as tagged by Plato, can live a life full of peace, development, justice, equity, and happiness. Mind you, We have been confronted with how to find solutions to justice, peace, development, and what have you, which human societies are still, you know, grappling with. This seems to be a generic position. Hence, they narrowed their definition of political thought to the discipline investigation of political problem. Although political thought is not a systematized body of knowledge as political theory, because political theory is a systematized, you know, body of knowledge. And there is the tendency to use both terms interchangeably. They should not be used. That is, political thought is more or less an aspect of political philosophy, that is, considering of a series of opinions, assumptions, and even the theory, most of which are based on any empirical evidence. That is, the base on the deduction, partly from logic and partly from sensuous, you know, perception. It is carved out partly from logic and partly from a sensuous perception of the world, of the author's society and age. Such knowledge is limited by both its social environment and by limitation in development of society. Finally, from the foregoing, one can safely state that political thought is the disciplined investigation of political problem in the society, which aims at arriving at positive and worthwhile ideas, which implemented could free the society from its problems or predicament. So, in a nutshell, what I've been giving to you is the understanding of the political thought, how political thought came in man's, you know, intuitive and logical reasoning, and how it has been the foundation of the phenomenon of solving societal problems. Mind you that human beings are the most complex and the most difficult entity to actually control. And as a result of this, it behoves on us, the political scientists, to know how to provide, if not lasting solution, but to provide solution to the matter of societal problems. And finally, according to Albert Einstein, one of the greatest scientists, said politics is much more difficult than physics. What he was trying to tell us during his lifetime was and is still that to control human beings is the most difficult things to do. Therefore, I round up this study session 1, and I want you go through your materials and equally apply the knowledge which I've given to you on the video. Meet you another time on study session 2 on post 313. Thank you.